Happy birthday, guys. I mean, to me, this has been an incredible decade. When you think back at the last 10 years, where HasGeek started with early events focused on HTML5, focused on PHP, and from there, just the spread of things that HasGeek has gone on to do, it's absolutely mind-boggling. To me, I look back at the last decade as a decade where overall the tech community of India came of age in many, many, many different ways, right? We went from, you know, to me, like the early 2000s were still a decade where we were building software mainly with services companies or MNCs that were mainly doing more of low-end maintenance work out of India, to the last decade where, one, the nature of the work MNCs were doing significantly stepped up, and two, the nature of global startups coming out of India significantly increased. And HasGeek to me has been a key ecosystem enabler, a key catalyst that has enabled the startup community to flourish and to bring like-minded individuals in the community together to exchange ideas and to propel innovation much further down along the way than would have otherwise been possible. I personally have known the HasGeek team now for 10 years, and I've been a part of multiple events, mostly the mobile events, but also cloud, data science, and front-end development and engineering as well. And across all of these, I have met incredibly smart people. Incredibly smart people, both from big companies, it could be Google, Intuit, Facebook, Amazon, to little startups, from Little Eye Labs to others, who've all been a part of key exchange of ideas and a multiplying factor in this ecosystem. We've exchanged ideas, we have sat down on birds of the feathers discussions, we have brainstormed open source ideas, we have caught up and just even made friends who have hung out outside of these events and gone on to do other things together. To me, there's a few things that make HasGeek very unique, and I think it's important that as you look to the future, that we continue to retain these. And one of them is a very principled approach to thinking about communities and just how you go about building HasGeek itself. And I think all along the way, Kiran, Zainab, and everyone else in the team has always tried to stay true to the community, ensuring that commercial interests in hiring don't get in the way. While that might be something that enabled, they've always protected the interests of the community and put them first. And this principle actually translates into a number of things. It translates into code of conduct. It translates into diversity. It translates into choices with respect to little things that you do on a day-to-day basis that come together with respect to the space that you create for like-minded people to come together. And there's a lot of thought backed by principles where this team could have gone out and chosen other options that might have made them money in the short term, but they're really focused on creating something that has had a huge impact to the community long term and has their trust and faith. And to me, there's still a few other things. One is fun. Whether it's the HasGeek logo, whether it's the logos of the events, whether it's the graphics, whether it's the posters, there's a sense of fun that brings like-minded geeks together in ways that few other people can. And this is unique to HasGeek. The events are fun, developers love it, and I would love to see you continue to retain this element irrespective of what you do, and continue to see this take different shape in whichever form you may apply it to. The third to me was just listening to the community. Even while the events got bigger, the speakers got bigger, and the scale at which things started to happen started to increase more and more, HasGeek has done a good job of listening to the community and trying to understand what the community really needed and continuing to raise the bar in numerous areas. And this extends right from the way in which speakers are curated to the way they work with speakers to help improve content to even the way they bring people in the community together focused on different themes that matter to the community at large, where one year the team may be focused on something which is a little more topical and also even going on to break out separate events. Just as an example, they broke out an event on deep learning separate from other big data topics to provide a lot more attention and focus based on what the community really needed. So again, HasGeek, congrats to everyone in the team who's been a part of this journey, and you have a number of alumni who are proud of everything that you guys are doing. To me, again, when I look back at the last decade, if I think of startups and how we've evolved, HasGeek to me has been a single key reason why we're seeing the growth that we're seeing overall. For me personally, I ended up getting connected to one of the co-founders of Cloudcherry that I joined through someone I met via HasGeek, and went on to be part of the journey at Cloudcherry, where we ended up even hiring someone who came in through one of the HasGeek events, and he ended up being one of our top front-end developers. And then Cloudcherry ended up being acquired by Cisco, and now we're WebEx Experience Management. And even here today at Cisco, when I think about how we're looking to innovate and key talent that we would be looking out for, to me, HasGeek communities, the people here will always be top of mind. Thank you, everyone, and once again, happy birthday, HasGeek.